Hey everybody, I've got a real lackluster selection of empties for you. If that doesn't sell the video, I don't know what will. not the greatest. I haven't been saving them up for that long. But you know, there's some good products in there that I can talk about. So if you like empties videos, hang around. If you don't watch this. Okay, so let's start out with something that was making me really ill and have very bad health. Doesn't that seem like a great place to start out? I put this in a favorites video. This is Arid Extra Extra Dry Solid. It's like a super strength deodorant. If you also notice in the video where I talk about how great this is, I'm very ill and I'm like, oh, I feel like I'm gonna throw up. This was a deodorant that Ryan bought for himself. And then he didn't like it, so he stopped using it. And it smells nice, you know? Nice whiff. It smells good. But don't fucking use it. And I take back anything good I ever said about it, except for the fact that it is quite effective, but the side effect is you'll feel like you're dying. Backstory, I think I kind of talked about it in a video, but I didn't have, you know, the product in hand. Here's the deal. I started using this, and I started feeling very, very nauseous. Very sick, and it was a confusing time because I had just gotten food poisoning and was throwing up like crazy over Thanksgiving, and it was around the time that I was using this, and I was violently ill, very fucking ill. And then ever since then, I wasn't able to kick feeling really nauseous and gross, and I figured out that it was this after like a month of feeling like I was gonna throw up at any moment, that I was totally lightheaded and that I could pass out at any moment. Am I suffering from malnutrition? Am I pregnant? Am I dying? Do I have cancer? All things that ran through my head. Turns out it was just a fucking deodorant, but it was really, really bad. And it was only like when I was going places and hanging out with people, because it was the only time I would put this deodorant on. So it took me a while to put two and two together. And I thought it was maybe drinking, because I would put this on, go out to meet up with my friends, have like a couple sips of alcohol and just be like, oh my God, I don't feel good, like I need to leave, and just feel terrible. But I would just kind of like sit there like just heart racing, lightheaded, feeling really panicky, terrible, but at the same time, like I was gonna throw up at any moment. And I don't get like barfy hangovers from alcohol, so I was like, I don't understand what's going on. Am I becoming like not able to drink alcohol? Which would be terrible. Not really, I don't really drink that much. But anyways, it was this. Don't fucking use this. You might die. But if you wanna sponsor me, I'm just kidding. okay. Don't fucking use that product, I'm serious. My mom got so excited and she had me take a pregnancy test. She was like, maybe I'm getting a grandkid. And I was like, you're definitely not. Next up, a body scrub. This will make us feel better, right? This is the Soul Sunday Florence Body Scrub. I really like it. It's a coffee scrub. As you can see, like little coffee granules mixed with an essential oil blend. You'd see this little bottle and you wouldn't realize it, but this shit lasts and lasts and lasts. Maybe, ooh, I hope I didn't get some, got some on my nose. Oh well. It smells great. It always felt like it was zesty and woke me up. I think I talked about it in a favorites video. But yeah, so coffee grounds are much tinier than like a traditional salt or sugar scrub, so you can pack a lot more into a tiny thing. So this little guy probably lasted me like 20, 30 uses, something like that. So if you get the larger size, hey, that's gonna last you forever. Good bang for your buck. Plus you get the benefit of being all natural vegan product. Sell that in Anime. They also make a great deodorant. Speaking of deodorants, that's the all natural one. Use the Pits, don't use Arid. PSA. Okay, let's go with some hair products. Yeah, Arnco Moon Shine Conditioner, Jackpot Styling Cream, and Moon Shine Shampoo. These were Space NK samples, and I was on a little R&Co kick because when I got my haircut with Onkatron, this was the brand that he was like super obsessed with, this and Orbea, which they're the sister companies. The Jackpot Styling Cream was nice. I'm not a huge styling cream person. I think I'm more of a paste person. But I did like this one after the shower, but it's just like after a shower, if I'm putting a styling cream in, I want it to be something that's a little bit of a styling cream and a little bit of a product, like a mending, something that's gonna have some benefit to my hair. If your hair's not crazy damaged, then you can probably just go the styling cream route, but I try to look for something that's gonna be beneficial as well as being somewhat of a styling product. So I probably won't be purchasing this while I'm blonde, but maybe in the future. And then the Shine shampoo, this smelled really, really good. I really liked it, and I would totally consider purchasing it because I like their branding, their packaging, all that jazz. I'm a sucker. They got me on the hook, and I'm just like, I'll buy whatever you want. Okay, cotton rounds, whatever. Next up, Mishell Dermaceuticals White Cranberry Cleanser. Just whatever. I was traveling. I needed a travel cleanser. Bought it at Whole Foods. You can do that too if you feel like it. I'm not really gonna sway you towards it, but it worked. It served its purpose. I liked it. Kula Classic Sunscreen. I think I got this in a Birchbox, and it was one of those things where I don't foresee myself ever purchasing it, so I will put it on my neck and protect my neck skin so that when I'm old, it is not wrinkly and give away my age as being 65 when my face looks 25 from all of the plastic surgery and other things that I've gotten, my nip tucks and whatnot. So, you know, that's just a life plan. It's actually not. I don't want to get plastic surgery unless it's like really good plastic surgery that no one will be able to tell you got. Or have I gotten it already? You may never know. Living Proof Restore Mask Treatment for dry and damaged hair. Living Proof, I love how the stuff smells. It's hard to put my finger down and actually describe the smell besides for like clean hair product smell. But I loved this mask a lot. This is definitely something that I would repurchase. I don't know why, but I'm just really drawn to Living Proof as a brand, even though their packaging isn't like the most amazing thing in the world and it's not totally up my alley, but it definitely is something that I like. And if you're in the UK, I'm not saying that their packaging is up my butt, which I've discovered that's what up my alley means there, up your tuchus. Yeah, it's funny how there's that slight difference. Anyways, whatever. Let's get a product that everybody loves. The Ren Glycolactic Radiance Renewal Mask. It was a very sad day when I pumped, and no more of this came out. I shed a tear, and I was a little sad, and I was like, fuck, I have to buy another one. It's not what I want to do right now. I don't want to spend money on shit. So this is an amazing mask that I will always own one of, and I've been desperately needing it lately because my skin grows real fucking quick. When I was a little kid, I hope this story doesn't actually like explain like a crazy like disorder I had as a child that didn't know, and it's like a precursor for like, oh yeah, you're gonna die of this disease when you're like 30. But anyways, when I was a kid, I think it was because I had too much sugar. I would get rashes a lot, and then I don't know if this was related to sugar, but I would have like eye crusties every single day when I woke up. And they were like pretty thick. I didn't have pink eye every day in my life, I can assure you that. But it was almost as if it was like that kind of, sometimes how you can get kind of like crusties from pink eye. And they would be all up in my eyelash, and it was like my eyelid skin was growing too fast. And every single morning before school, my mom would have to lay me on the couch, and she would have to say, I would be like, say something sad so that like I could water my eyes a little bit and it would make it easier for them to come off my eyelids. And she'd be like, Free Willy died. And I'd be like 5 years old, and I'd be like, that's so sad. And then I would like cry a little bit, and then they were able to like pick them off easier. That's not a normal thing, right? Lots of kids didn't have that experience of having to cry so their eye crusties would come off easier every morning before school, right? So we even went to the doctor about it, I remember, and they were just like, I don't know, your skin grows really fast. But now I'm just having that problem on my face. It just feels like there's just not enough exfoliation in the world can help me out, because I feel like my makeup is always clinging to dry skin patches. Not that I have dry skin, it's like I have too much skin. So this thing really kept that at bay, and now that I don't have it, I'm like grasping at straws. Before I put my makeup on, I'm like trying to scrub my face with a washcloth. Then I'm trying to like put on Paula's Choice, some sort of like exfoliant, and just like kill all the dead skin cells before I put my makeup on, please, so they don't like, you know, crust up together. So that's just like what I'm going through right now. It's not very fun to put makeup on because I'm just like, oh, is it gonna like in 2 hours I'm gonna look in the mirror and be like, what the fuck? Yeah, so anyways, something else, right? Buy the Ren thing, it's very good, especially if you have a crusty eye issue. Brilliantine from Bumble and Bumble. I like this. It's probably not thick enough for a styling cream that I would want nowadays. I bought this a very long time ago. I liked it for kind of getting a little bit of a PC look. I think I like a PC-er look. So this is not something I'll probably ever purchase again. And this tube I have owned since I was about 18 years old. So I opened it recently and it smelled like garbage. It smells like a garbage can's butthole. So I decided to throw it away. Similar story with this guy right here. The Origins Ginseng Refreshing Eye Cream to Brighten and Depuff. Throwback to YouTube about 3 years ago. This was like an it product, probably when Origins was feeding people a lot of, you know, product PR samples or something. But it was a nice product to like put underneath your eyes if you're not wearing any makeup and you're just like going down to the store and you want to have like a little bit of a depuff thing going on and a little bit of a shine. It was an okay product. I will probably never buy it again. I liked it at the time, but now that I've used more and more and more, I have different preferences and likes, and this doesn't necessarily meet up to all of them, but it also smells like a trash can's butthole, and I don't feel confident putting it near my eye holes, so I don't want to do that. I think the trash can is a better place for it. Another Bumble and Bumble product is the Bumble Bumble Semi Sumo. This smells like heaven. It smells very, very good. I love this product a lot. I bought this, I think I saw some like Man Repeller article where she said she used it, which was so silly of me to buy into the hype because it was obviously a Bumble and Bumble sponsor thing, but whatever. So I bought the Semi Sumo. I loved it. Ryan was using Crew. I was like, please stop using that garbage. My cell phone keeps dinging because I'm a very popular. I have about 3 friends. You know, we talk to each other about once per year. It's very great. You just don't have the time to be me. Bumble Bumble Semi Sumo. He was using Crew, which is like disgusting, and it's the basic bitch hair product for men. You know, you buy it at your barbershop, it costs $8, all this shit. I told him, I was like, start using my damn Semi Sumo, please. So he did. Then he used up my whole damn jar like a little bitch. And then I bought him this Shu Uemura Clay Definer, which he's also using up. I guess I shouldn't complain because this is what I was asking for. But then I'm like, God damn it, now I gotta get another one. Anyways, so I told my cousin Neil, I was giving him the whole like Crew is for basic bitches spiel at Christmas or a little bit before. And he was like, what the hell? It's so much better. It's so cheap. It works well. And I was like, listen, you gotta get Semi Sumo. He didn't listen to me for a while. And then like 2 or 3 weeks ago, he like texted me. He's like, what's that thing you said to get? And I told him, and he bought it, and he like texted me a picture when it came. And then he texted me like, this shit's garbage. And I was like, no, it is not. You need to get used to it. You need to use it and everything will be good. Just, you know, get accustomed to it. Don't use your Crew shit anymore. And then I saw him again. He was like, no, fuck this. And then like 2 days later, he texted and he was like, okay, it's love hate. I really love it right now. So Neil approved, depending on his mood or the day or how his hair is doing. Ryan loves it. You know, we could go with either one of these for the boys' hair, and we share either one because I like a pasty, twisty, broken up look in my hair. And I think I only have 2 more things to talk about. Then I'm gonna watch Teen Mom. Okay. Teakwood and Tobacco Candle. This is my little tester one. And smells so good. I mean, I've talked about these 10,000 million times. I discovered them at a Renegade craft fair a long time back. Then once I opened Anomie, Kristen was the first company that I contacted as that I wanted to carry in the store. So that's our origin story. And now I have a collab candle with them, the vanilla plum one, and they just smell so good. At any given moment, there's about 6 different scents placed somewhere within my house. It smells really good too if you burn 2 together. That's a big thing. They're big on the pairing. Like, oh, put lavender with this one, and then the 2 scents together combine in the air and they smell really nice. But PF Candle Co. candles, I loves them. And last product, another eye cream, except this one didn't start smelling like butthole. This one just got used up. And this was the Shiseido Benefiance Wrinkle Resist 24. It was a very moisturizing feeling eye cream. I don't know how much it was necessarily moisturizing because it was just more of like a greasy eye cream than the Aesop one that I'm using now, but it's like, how do you really know which one works better? Is moisturizing, like, are you being deceived by the fact that it's like really oily and you're thinking it's being moisturized, or is it actually, I don't know. I've never done like blind test studies of on my own eye skin to see which one I like better. So anyways, I like this one a lot and I'd buy it again. That's all I say. It's kind of expensive. I think the first time I bought it, I got it with like a gift card. That was like a Christmas present, but I would spend my hard earned money on this bad boy, or another gift card if someone wants to send me one. My birthday is coming up in a couple months. Anyways, this has been my empties video. I hope you have a good day. Hey, do you like these glasses on me? Or do they look stupid? I like a clear frame, but I'm just not really sure they go with like me. In my head, I always envisioned myself, that wasn't a good look. I always envisioned myself like someday having bleach blonde hair up in a bun and like working at an art gallery. I would never want to work at an art gallery, but it was like a little fantasy person that I would try to dress up as. But these are Warby Parker. Bless my dear soul. These are Warby Parker Huxley's. And then I also have these Beckett's in Aquatonic. And maybe is the blue better for me, or are both of these very bad? I don't wear glasses. They don't actually have lenses in them. But Ryan has some Warby Parkers that he wears because he needs goggles now. And he might put lenses in those. I don't know. I just don't feel like leaving you guys. I can't push stop on the record button. No, I can, and I will. Have a good day. Bye.